experience in Africa. So Vimal Bhai Shah is there with us. So he's chairman of Bidco Group Africa. So I would like to invite him, Vimal sir. If you can throw up some light, what is happening in Africa? Because in COVID, the world is on the same stage. So we are on the same platform almost. Everybody is trying some innovation. And I think Africa is leapfrogging into digital. I heard you in your last, the previous session I attended, where you said a very high about Africa going digital. So can you please throw us some light that how HealthTech is performing there and what all opportunities are there?
Thanks, Rishabh. I think Africa is moving quite fast. The only problem is that we don't have the manpower or the expert doctors and all that stuff available here. So what we've been doing is a lot of outsourcing of our healthcare to India, and we have medical tourism as a big affair. But digital now has changed a lot of things. So digital healthcare is coming in. A lot of the hospitals here, the doctors have been changing their mindsets. We even had a problem with approving telemedicine in Kenya. Now telemedicine is approved, it's there. Within next 1 week, they will actually allow telemedicine to operate here. The only problem is there was a doctor's lobby that was saying, we cannot allow any foreign doctor to treat anybody here. But hey, you know, people are going to India and getting treated there. Yes. People are going online on calls, on video calls right now, and talking to doctors in India and getting treated. And they don't mind any of the legalities, they just good. Do it. So digital healthcare right now is in an open space. I think it's going to take off very well. The authorities have also realized that we don't have the manpower and the people available. Wherever it's available from, do it. So I think that's an opportunity existing. A lot of the digital healthcare systems and the platforms that you talk about haven't even explored Africa yet, because I think they look at the big market in India and say that's the biggest market. But this is open space. Now if we want to be pretty much available. What we need is POC, a proof of concept. You've got a proof of concept that it's worked, it's operating already in India, and it can be done here. That same thing, you just replicate. You don't, you just do cut and paste. And you know, on the spot, start moving it here. So possibilities are many. However, what is important is trust. And I think this is a crucial part. If I go into an app or whatever, I only download it if I've been told by somebody trustworthy. How do you develop that trust? Because I could have 50 apps today and I don't know which one to trust. So this is where the whole magic is. And if you can actually establish that, the credibility is established, all the approvals are there. I think this is pretty much a good open space for everybody to work.
So sir, as you are in agriculture.
One more thing, there is no capex because you're already doing something in India. All you need to do is allow it here. Zero capex and you can be working on a revenue sharing model.
Because yesterday I was with Israel embassy in India, so there are a lot of Israeli health tech startups who are now planning to enter into India because they have developed very advanced technology, and in their investment model, they don't invest a single dollar. They say that we will give you technology, you invest money and you run in your country, we will take a royalty. So from the investment point of view, this model from India can be replicated in Africa. There are a lot of businessmen who would love to have the control, exclusivity, and then you offer them the service. Because the proven service if can be offered,
technology
it
as
can
a service,
be wonderful.
Medicine as a service available. And I think there's no capex because you don't have to reinvent the wheel. It's already happening. You could even have doctors sitting in India and then treating people out here. The most important thing would be access to healthcare. And when people get, you know, you democratize it and you give access to people on a phone, and if healthcare is available on a phone, people opt in and say, fine. Even you can have a disclaimer and say, fine, if you want to get into this disclaimer, be signed on. So you don't have a legality problem. So
I think wonderful, sir. I think this is the era of disintermediation. The world is getting disintermediated. So there is no boundary, political boundary cannot stop the business. And the business is for the good reason, nobody can stop it, actually. Because that is the way Uber becomes successful. Overnight they become widespread. Now people are talking about the flaw in the business model. So we as a business expert like Rajiv, I would like to tell you, like to ask you that, you know, how the global Indian startup can become global startup. Because we have seen a lot of, we are talking about Google, IBM, Watson, but when we will start talking about some Indian startup going global, like your Fitbit becoming a next Fitbit worldwide.